Let's pass the address of our device pointer to the function. The second output is the future level pointer that indicates which of the future levels passed as input parameters has been chosen. As the previous one, let's add this pointer as member of the class. Last but not least, the third output is the immediate device context pointer that we'll deepen it in the next tutorials. For now, let's add even this pointer as member of the class. So far, so good. We have finished to pass all the necessary parameters. Now, let's get the return value and let's check it. If during the loop the createDevice succeed, we have no more reason to stay, so we will break our loop. Instead, if createDevice has not given positive result for each driver type passed, then we cannot do anything but return false. So good, we have just finished to initialize DirectX API. After we have arrived at this point, we can start to make the graphics engine class a singleton class. To do that, let's add the static method that returns a pointer to graphics engine instance and call it get. Let's implement it as usual with create declaration definition future. Here we have to add a static object of graphics engine class. For the fact that it is static, this object will be put on the stack and it will be created only once at program initialization. Each time this get function will be called, it will always get the address of the same instance. No more instances of this class will be created at runtime. We have almost finished. As last things, let's release all the resources created in release method that are device context and DirectX device. And as very last thing, let's go to our old friend window and let's initialize our graphics engine in onCreateEvent method. In the end, let's release the engine in onDestroyEvent method. That's all for now, folks. In this tutorial, we have thrown the foundations of our graphics engine, and we have managed the initialization and release of the DirectX graphics API. In the next tutorial, we will see what are the necessary steps to finally render the graphics on our window. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. See you soon! Thanks for watching!